Hi all, in this video tutorial I will show you how to create a login screen in your Windows application. So let's get started. This is my Visual Studio 2010. So we have to create a Windows application first. Go to File, then New, Project, otherwise you can use shortcut Ctrl Shift N. Then under Visual C Sharp, select Windows, then Windows application. Choose directory where you want to save this application. Name your application. Then click OK. After creating the project, you can the solution explorer. Your Windows application will be looked like this. There will be a default form named form 1. So in this case we don't need that. Now we need to add form for login. So right click on Windows application, then add new item. Under Visual C Sharp items, select Windows form. Name Windows form as form login, then click OK. This is our login form. Now we need to change some of the properties of this form. For that you have to right click on the form, then properties, otherwise select the form, click F4, change text as login, then start position as center screen, then set false for maximize box. So now we have a form for login. Now we need to add record controls for login. In this case you have to launch toolbox. In my case it is there in the left panel. If you are not able to see toolbox, go to view, then click toolbox, then drag controls like button, label, then text box. Now we need one more label. For that hold Ctrl key, then drag label. So here we have one copy of this control. In the same way we need one more text box and one more button. Now we need to change properties of this control. So go to properties, then change text as username, then password, name this text box something meaningful, txt username, txt password, btn login, change button text as login, and the last button as exit. BTN exit. Now we need to arrange these controls. changing control font to 10. Okay, now we have our login form. Now we need one more form, that is main screen. Forum main. Usually main screen will be big in size. Name font text as dashboard, and start position as center screen, then show icon to false, window stage give it normal. So far we have created screens for our Windows application. Now we need to create a database for our application. For that, go to view, then click on Server Explorer, right click on data connections, add connection, select a location where you want to save this database. Name your DB here, in my case this login DB, click on open, click OK, asking for whether we want to save it or not, create it or not, click on yes. Go to tables, there is no table, so now we want to create a table. Give column names, login ID, username varchar50, password okay 50, setting login ID as primary key. To create the table you have to save for that, press Ctrl S, name the table something like TVL login, click OK. In this case I'm going to add few login records directly into our login table. Login ID 1, username as user 1, password as QWERTY, login ID 2, user ID as user 2, password QAZ. Press Ctrl R to refresh. So now we have two login records for user 1 and user 2. Now we have our form design and our DB here. So now we can start coding. Basically, an application starts with login screen, then after authorizing the user using his username and password, if the user is authorized, then main screen will be open for him. So in our application, start form will be our login form, so we have to set our start form here by specifying forum login. So when the application starts, the login screen, login form will be open for the user. So in this login button click event, you have to check whether the user is authorized or not. For that, first of all, we need a SQL connection object. To use SQL connection object, we have to import or use system dot data dot SQL client. Then creating an object of SQL connection class SQL con new SQL connection, the red symbol, and within these two codes you have to specify the connection string for this DB. Right click on the DB, go to properties and select this text here and paste here. Remove these two extra codes. Okay. So we need to write our query. It will be something like this: select star from TBL login username equals txt username is the name of text box dot text dot trim to trimming the text box value to avoid extra white space from the both ends, and password equal to txt password text dot trim. So now we have a query here: select a star from login previous login, the username equals text in the text box for username, and password equals the text in the password text box. Now we need another object of class SQL data adapter, sta equals new SQL data adapter, and pass your query here. Then SQL connection object, creating an object of data table DTBL. New data table sta dot fill DTBL. If DTBL dot rows dot count equals 1 from me object form me. Dot show this dot height. Else check your username and password. So what we actually do is, here we have a query to select user records that satisfies username based on the username and password. So in this line, this data SQL data adapter dot fill, it will fill the selected rows into this table. So after that we will check number of rows in the table. If number of rows is equal to 1, there is a user for the given username and password. That must be user 1 or user 2. And password for user 1 must be QWERTY, and user 2, and for user 2 it must be QAZ. So if the data table contains one row, we will open the main screen like this. Otherwise we will pop up a message saying check your username and password. Okay, in this exit button click event, it write code for closing screen. So let me start for application started here. I'm going to enter a incorrect combination of password and username. User 100 password QAZ. Check your username and password. User 1 QWERTY as password. Click login. Main screen, main form will be opened. That means username and password is valid. So that's it. You can do one more thing for password text box to hide the password from. You can set password character here hashtag mark or something as you wish. So when you enter password, it will be shown like sequence of asterisk marks. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video and download this project from the link given below in video description. Please be subscribed to my channel for more. Have a nice day. Bye.